Underwriting is provided by Left Coast Classics, located at 255 West Napa Street, Suite E. For more information, you can go to leftcoastclassics.com. Krista Granton Insurance, located at 255 West Napa Street, Suite F. For more information, you can go to grantoninsurance.com. The Best Western Sonoma Valley Inn, located at 550 2nd Street West. For more information, you can visit their website at sonomavalleyinn.com. And Roseanne's Haircutting and Alani's Nails, located at 13750 Arnold Drive in Glen Ellen.
Hello, I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV's Filmmaker Interview Series here at the 2017 Sonoma International Film Festival, our 20th annual. And I have with me director Leanne Melissa Bishop and Michael P. Mason and Chris Boots Orchard, producer and visual effects, and they brought Candace and Peter's Smokin' Hot Date. And Leanne, you and Kelly and Michael came last year with the film Reservations for Three, and you're back as directors this year. So how does that work?
Oh my goodness, it's so exciting. We had a really great festival run last year, and one of the things that inspired us was being here at Sonoma. And, you know, all the food and the wine and everyone was so complimentary. And, like, we need to come back. People need to see more of this. So that was one of the reasons we actually made it, to be honest, is because we wanted to, you know, do the Sonoma thing. And, mm-hmm. you know, the food and the wine. So it's more of a companion piece to Reservations for Three. And it was amazing to direct it, especially because I'm also acting in it. So it was a bit of a feat to do it all. But just a wonderful, wonderful experience. I'm blessed.
So you and Kelly had starred in Reservations for Three, and you co-wrote this one, so it's great. And Sonoma Wine has a supporting role in your...
Yes, it does. Well, the Sonoma Film Festival, they took us on a wine tour last year at the Buena Vista Winery. We were so impressed, so when we decided to make the film this year, we're like, hey, let's reach out and see if we can use their wine. And not only could we use it, they came on board to sponsor us, and we had a lecture for ourselves.
That's Buena Vista for you. They're a great community partner. So your film is about, while cooking a romantic dinner at home, a tiff over which wine goes best with dinner escalates. So
yes.
That is perfect for the Sonoma International Film Festival.
So let me ask you, do you prefer red or white with pork?
You know, I don't drink, so but I understand pork can go either way, right?
It does seem to be a question that that everybody has a different answer to, so mm-hmm. Hence the sort of, you know, the birth of the premise of the film, and of course they end up on opposite sides of the argument, and as they did with Reservations for Three, the dinner goes awry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you don't seem to be able to get through a meal with Kelly, do you?
No.
So Chris, you are a producer and you bring the visual effects to the film. So what kind of visual effects can people expect from Candace and Peter's Smokin' Hot Date?
Well, hopefully they won't notice any visual effects.
Mm-hmm.
They're supposed to be invisible. Can I spoil the movie for people who are watching, right? While they're arguing, the kitchen catches fire, basically. The food catches fire. And mm-hmm. So in light of not wanting to set any actors on fire, decided to do it in post.
Right.
Although they almost did, as I understand, in camera.
Yeah, Michael, you got to share that story with us. So you almost, on day one, shot one, you almost burnt the set.
Yeah, we decided to start with the beginning of the film, would start some sort of, you know, in like a cooking show, and sort of close-ups, and we wanted some nice sizzle before the pork chops hit the hit the frying pan. So the idea was to how you sort of spray a little bit of water in the frying pan to get the sizzle to show. But I think Kelly misunderstood, and so he ended up pouring a bit of water, and it went up into a very small grease fire, which thankfully was put out before any damage was done. But it was a rather auspicious sort of first shot, which
set the mood.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
But thankfully, nobody was hurt and nothing was damaged, and we got on with the day. And
your DP just didn't take his camera
and
say, "I'm out of here.
I'm taking my ball and going home."
Yeah.
No, we managed to get through our day, and that was sort of not an omen, thankfully, for how the shoot was going to go.
Blooper reel, right?
Exactly, yeah. And it's actually the last shot. You know, when you see the film, the credits roll, and we usually we used it as the last shot after sort of the credit rolls. It pops up as just the very last shot.
Everybody's screaming in the background.
Yeah, you can sort of hear people going.
So you were talking as Bob was setting things up about kind of how this festival, and specifically the Sonoma International Film Festival, how you met and brought together. So talk a little bit about that, how the festival itself and coming with Reservations for Three brought about Candace and Peter's Smoking Hot Date.
Yeah, well, in particular, like I say, because, I mean, Sonoma's known for its food and wine, which I love. Mm-hmm. but that's, like, because the first one really was, you know, again, most of it took place over a dinner date. They were deciding, do we have a baby or not? About 2 months into our relationship, which was probably a little too early to be asking that question.
Hence the conflict of the script.
Exactly. And everyone loved the characters, so we decided to play on that and keep going forward. And, I mean, who in their life, whenever something big comes up, doesn't have food and wine? Or, you know, if you don't drink, if you're having, you know, some special drink that you really enjoy and, you know, your favorite chocolate or your favorite this or that, and what pairings go best together. So that's really where it came from. We just thought it would, something that everyone can identify with, because I feel like most things in my life, I'm like, oh, this was exciting. Oh, that was really crappy. I can draw back to what I was eating then. Mm-hmm. Maybe that was just me. and we wanted to come back to this festival.
Yeah, I think we knew right away after we had a fairly successful festival run with Reservations for Three, played in 18 festivals and won a bunch of awards.
Congratulations.
Nominated for some, thank you. Nominated for some other ones. But we knew, like, Sonoma right away was at sort of at the top of our list of one of our favorite festivals. And we knew we wanted to come back. And we knew that just from the reception of the film that there was a lot of people who were sort of asking, well, what happened before and what happens after? Do they have the baby? And so we wanted to continue the characters. And so we decided, well, we're going to make another film. And it just seemed natural to include, you know, food and wine because of sort of where it was sort of inspired. And we actually met Chris here.
Yeah, we met him here last year.
Right here in Sonoma.
Exactly.
Yeah, he had a different film at the festival.
Reset, yeah.
And mm-hmm. called Reset. And so we met and became friendly. And you know, there was talk of, well, we should work together on something. And when we did this film, we didn't have, you know, practical fire on set. We were using a bit of practical smoke, but smoke is difficult to give direction to. It tends to do what it wants.
It did not listen to me at all.
It's like the wind, right?
So we realized very quickly that we were going to need to enhance that in post, and also wanted to add some flames just to help, you know, sort of sell it. And so we got on the phone with Chris and sort of said, hey, you remember he said you wanted to work with us? Well,
do you remember that night when we had a jello shot at Steiner's?
It's really funny because you meet the most amazing people at the Sonoma Film Festival, and the community is such a big supporter of it, which is great to see as a filmmaker, too. But we were, we met basically in a party, an impromptu party in an office somewhere. With Leah Rinaldo and Michael Howell.
From the Devour Food and Film Festival.
So we just need to make a film that will have food in it, and we can submit it. And I thought we were joking.
Uh-huh. We weren't.
But 4 months later, we had the film finished and ended up over in Nova Scotia at the Devour Festival.
Yeah.
And so thrilled to be back here.
We don't believe in messing around. Just get it done.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's exciting. And where's Kelly today?
Fortunate for him, not for us. A film that he actually directed is playing in South France on Monday.
Ooh.
So he had to travel there.
Uh-huh.
For him.
So he's off the Cannes for the Cannes Diversity Film Festival that's happening there right now for it's his directorial debut actually. So he's excited.
And
about
he was planning to come here all along, and then he found a way to get there. So good for him.
Mm-hmm. Well, I can't wait to see what you bring to the next Sonoma International Film.
Well, we're working on a feature right now, and with any luck, we'll be showing sort of, you know, on September and ready to submit next year. So you may see us back here interviewing for a feature. So,
all right,
it's called What If. So be on the lookout for it.
What If?
Yes.
Very exciting.
Yeah.
Very exciting. Your film this year, Candace and Peter's Smokin' Hot Date, director Vision, Michael P. Mason, and Chris Boots Orchard, producer and visual effects. I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV at the 2017 Sonoma International Film Festival, and this is our filmmaker interview series.